What's up, guys? Pete Moriarty here. So good to be here with you today. In this video, I'm going to be covering some pretty damn awesome stuff. I've got everything you need to know to be an absolute Google Workspace superstar. Now, we have gone through all of our little best practice tips for both admins, for novice users, for those that are maybe even just signing into Gmail for the first time. And I'm going to show you right from some of the basic things that everyone's just got to have right up to some really cool advanced tips and tricks as well. So grab yourself a cup of tea, sit down and enjoy this stuff. So let's get into it. Guys, we're here today to talk about how to be a Google Workspace superstar. And if you don't know who we are IT Genius. We're a small business consultancy, and we help small and medium-sized businesses to grow and to prosper and to play a bigger game. And we do that with a really solid technology strategy. We believe that businesses that have technology strategy in place can have an unfair advantage in the marketplace. And so that's what we help small and medium-sized businesses with. For you to be a technology-led company. And when you're a technology-led company and you've got a good technology strategy, where you can really outstrip the, let's say the legacy operators in your industry. We're really all about helping you to play that bigger game. And that means that you've got to have a bit of an unfair advantage. That's what we're all about creating. Now, we help businesses right from launch and startup stage through growth stage, scale, and beyond as well through our partners. Most of the businesses we work with, though, are in the growth stage. So they've got a couple of employees. They've got their tech setup kind of done. But maybe things aren't working out perfectly. Maybe things are a little bit of a mess. Your Google Drive is a little bit disorganized. Maybe your staff aren't putting tasks in the right place, or maybe you're doing tasks on email right now. We know all of these kind of problems start to pop up when a company has more than one or two or three people in the business. Now, if you're a launch business or a startup business, doesn't mean you can't work with us. We have programs and support offerings for everyone. But if you're someone who's super cost conscious and you've taken a look at our website and decided that concierge is not for you, then check out all the other videos on our library on YouTube. We've got heaps of stuff there to help you, support you, to get from launch to startup and then to a place where you can engage your services. Then, obviously, as you grow, we want to help graduate you to be a scale company. Our new growth KPI for our business and our impact KPI for the business is helping companies graduate from growth businesses to scale businesses. Because what we know is that when a company has at least 20 humans in the business and roughly around there, the business owner is able to take a step back. The business owner is able to actually enjoy a little bit more freedom in their life. And I've been able to be location independent for over 5 years now, been able to work from anywhere, been able to have a lot more time to myself. I have 4-day weekends, which I've had for 3 years now. And so I only work Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And we want to help create that life for more of our customers and more of our audience, which is you. So if you're excited by that, why don't you drop me a little comment? If you're on the live stream, drop me a little comment and say, fuck yeah, I'm excited, Pete. Excuse the French, guys. So this is the journey that we take businesses through. And if you are interested in a free consultation, you can have a chat to our team about that. All right. Now, the future, or what was the future, the present is now remote. We've had an amazing year of change, and everyone has been forced into this change or taken this change on by the horns of the bull and got excited about it. Work is now remote. And we've been talking about this for years and years, and Google has been a company that's been able to work flexibly for years and years. But the reality is now here. And Google Workspace has made a massive impact. Google have made some really big changes to the way that Workspace has all of the stuff kind of in one place now inside your Gmail. And that's really the aim for them, and the new branding around Workspace is about all your work in one place. Now, Workspace now has 2.6 billion users, which is just absolutely ridiculous. I mean, even Gmail itself has over 2 billion users. Workspace is just growing at an amazing rate. Now, what I want to do is take you through some of the best features and how to use them. And so let's take it away. Number one is Google Cloud Search. And this is a feature that is not known by many who are working in the Google world. Now, Google Cloud Search is your search bar. It's like your Google for everything that's in your G Suite, Google Workspace account. Now, Cloud Search is important because as you're working and your day-to-day tasks, you want to be as efficient and productive as possible. And what we see quite often is for small business owners, they get trapped. And trapped by having too many apps. And not only do you have subscription fatigue if you have 10 different apps to do 10 different things, but actually finding and sorting your information can take a lot of time. And there was a survey that was done, I don't have the slide here, but it was something along the lines of 30% of time is spent each day searching for or researching for information for the average knowledge worker. And this tool, Google Cloud Search, basically can rapidly reduce the amount of time that you spend searching for things, because this is a search tool that allows you to actually search through the whole of your Google account. And so this is going to help you to not lose information and not double up your time if you create a document or you store a document and then you misplace it and you have to recreate it. And let's be honest, that happens time to time to the best of us. So I'm going to show you some of the basics of Google Cloud Search. You can access it. It's very easy. You just go to cloudsearch.google.com. Now, you do need to be on a business plan. And so if you're on a business plan, that's the only way that you're going to get access to it. And you need to be on at least the business standard plan. So not the basic plan, the standard plan, which is the kind of like what was G Suite business. And so this is going to give you access to the Cloud Search tool. If you can't see it, it may not be enabled for your domain. So you can always get in touch with our team and we'll help enable it for you. Now, the first thing you'll notice when you open up the Cloud Search screen is that automatically it's opening up documents that I've accessed recently. And so it's basically bringing up information that's sitting in my Google Drive in documents that I've used recently. And you can also see here, it's brought up my latest and my next meeting that's coming up, which I'm basically in right now. And so inside there, it's basically automatically bringing up information. And it's using machine learning and AI to do that. Basically, it's looking at, okay, well, what has Pete accessed recently? What meetings does Peter have coming up? You know, if I have a document attached to a meeting or if anyone has attached a document to a meeting, it might say, hey, Pete, you know, this might be something that you're interested in checking out. Next up, you can see here, this document it's brought up because Angel has edited that document today and I also opened it. Here's another one that I opened and here's yet another one that Jing edited and shared with me today. So it's basically using machine learning to predict, well, what kind of documents might Pete be interested in? But the most powerful part of this is actually the ability to search right across all the tools in the organization. And so here in the search box, let me actually show the screen properly. If I type in something like Cebu Conference, right? I know that we've had some conferences with our team in Cebu. I'm gonna open up Cebu Conference. You can see here all of the documents, emails, there's a group conversation, there's a Google site that mentions Cebu Conference. Somebody's resume mentions the word Cebu and conference. Effectively, this is searching the whole of my Google account for absolutely everything that is available that Google can see into. Now, not only is it going to open documents in my Google Drive and emails inside my Gmail, it's even going to look into Google Keep Notes. It will bring those up. Basically, absolutely anything inside the Google account that has a search function, it's going to allow me to peek into those. And so that is a really, really powerful little tool. I have it open in a tab pretty much every day there. It just kind of sits there available for me. That's how we search inside a business. Now, it will also have some advanced features for larger companies. And so if you are a business who's in like scale mode or you've even reached like, you know, accelerate mode, you've got, you know, more than 20 employees and you may have some kind of local file storage infrastructure. Well, you can even use Cloud Search to connect to that local infrastructure. There's a connector tool, and that connector tool will actually allow you to connect to your local file systems, index them in Google inside of Cloud Search, and then actually will allow you to have them available online, which is pretty damn cool. It's the easiest way for all of your team to search right across the organization. Okay, so I have a question here from Ben, and Ben has asked, typically the homepage for Google Workspace is Gmail. What's my favorite homepage for team members, and is Cloud Search a good option? Ben, I would say that Cloud Search is definitely a good option for your homepage. I tend to go into Gmail, but for most people, I don't publicly recommend you go straight into Gmail because I don't like going into my email first thing in the morning. I'm more likely to go into chat and, you know, check in on conversations with the team, or I might go into my Asana tool and see what tasks I have on today and prioritize my work before I go and get jump and potentially get lost in a Gmail. But I'm going to share some tips in a upcoming video section on how to get the most out of Gmail, which I think you'll enjoy. But Cloud Search is certainly a good option for you to have as a homepage. Remember that Google Drive also has a priority view, and that acts in the same way in bringing up documents. And so if you're a knowledge worker who spends a lot of their time working on documents. That's the, you know, most of your job. You might choose to have the priority view inside of Google Drive as the primary place that you work. And so I'll show you guys what that looks like. Inside your Google Drive, you can see here I've got my priority view, which brings up all these different lists of documents. And in the same way with AI and machine learning, shares documents across the top. But obviously my search bar inside of Drive is only going to search stuff in Drive. So the best search to use is Google Cloud Search. But thanks for the question, Ben. That's a good one. All right, let's jump into our next section.